Hey guys, I'm Ganesh and you're watching Gadget Kada. So in this episode, we have the OnePlus 6 and we have the latest update in it, which is the Oxygen OS 5.1.6. So let's just see what all features are in this update. Along with that, we'll also show you how you can get the 5.1.6 update. So without further ado, let's roll. So the first update is that the Idea Vault services in India. So currently they had an issue with the Idea Vault services, which they have fixed, and the Idea Vault is currently working perfectly. The next update is like they have fixed stability issues for dual SIM cards. So currently I have only single SIM card, but anyway, I have tested it with dual SIM cards as well and it works perfectly. So that is also an update. So that is regarding the network. So the next update is for the camera in the portrait mode. If I go into the portrait mode, as you can see, there is these bokehs. So you can check out these bokeh shapes. You can change these bokeh shapes and you can preview them. Like if I see the heart shaped, I can see the heart shape bokehs in the image itself, and once I click the picture, I get almost similar image, although it's not accurate, but it does just job. So it is weird actually, but it's cool. It's really cool that you can view the bokehs beforehand itself. So it's really handy, like the star shapes. If I click a picture of the star bokehs, it'll take some time for it to make it like that. So as you can see, the star bokehs are here, so I can preview the bokeh even before like getting it. So that is a one feature, fun update. The next update is the portrait mode. So the portrait mode now has a front facing as well. So I can, as you can see, if I go to the portrait mode, I have something known as like this button, so that if I click it, it'll change into the front facing camera as well. So as you can see, I can see my camera itself. I'll focus on the camera, so the background should be blurred. And if I click a picture, it is not so accurate, but it's good. It's not so great. I'll also show you pictures of myself in front of the camera as well. So as you can see, it has a portrait mode, front facing portrait mode as well, and it's pretty good compared to other phones. It is really good. So yeah, so that is the other feature. Then what they have like added is like they have optimized the call quality. Earlier the call quality was not so good, but now it's better. And they have also supported one feature, which is the percentage in battery. So as you can see, currently I can only see the battery percentage if I swipe down. So other than that, I am not able to see the battery percentage. So if I want to see the battery percentage from the status bar here itself, I'll have to first go to the settings, and in the settings I have a under customization, there is status bar. You have the battery style and you can select battery percentage. If I choose that, as you can see the battery percentage here itself. I'll show you close up. Yes, you can see, I can see the battery percentage in the status bar itself. So that is a pretty handy feature, which I thought was a flaw in the previous version, and I thought it would have been better if I could see the battery percentage without swiping down. So they have bought that feature in, which is really good. And let's see the next feature, which is improved volume and the ringtone volume and the sound quality. So the sound quality and the ringtone volume has been improved. So I'll have to check it. So be on the community tab. We'll post in the community tab how good it is. So the next one is the scheduled do not disturb mode. So the do not disturb mode is pretty handy. So I can schedule the do not disturb mode such that if I am at office or stuff like that, so I can just hold on and there is something known as auto toggle. So if I switch it on, I can set the time from time to time so that it'll automatically turn on the do not disturb mode, which I think it is pretty handy for those who use do not disturb mode frequently. So that is another feature which they have added. And then they have added dual 4G network option in SIM and network settings, and also they have optimized the power consumption. So the power consumption is improved and the battery performance has improved. So I'll have to check that as well, and I'll update you in the community tab if the battery performance has actually improved or not. So the next one is the earphone mode. So if you have like a Bluetooth earphones or like when you are in a call in a Bluetooth earphones, cut. So if you have a Bluetooth earphones like these, so if I have a Bluetooth earphones and if I get a call while I'm playing music or something, then automatically it will switch on the call and it will, like, we can, there is an option so that you can get the call automatically, so without taking the phone. So it would be pretty handy while driving and stuff like that. So if you're doing something like jogging and you get a call, you can automatically set it to pick up, so you can order, like, answer the calls in the Bluetooth devices. So these are the updates which have come up in the Oxygen OS 5.1.6 update. In order to get the latest update of the Oxygen 5.1.6 and the future updates as well, first go to Play Store and download this application, which is known as Oxygen Updater. So once you download this application and open it, what you get is you will have to swipe right and swipe left, sorry, and swipe left again and swipe left. It will automatically choose your OnePlus, or if you want, you can choose it, and then you just give access and close, and then click incremental update. You have to choose incremental update, then you are ready to go. That's it. Then, as you can see, I have the latest update which is available, which is Oxygen OS 5.1.6. You can see all the bug fixes which have been done and all the new features which have come up. So just click on the download button and allow it. So once that's run, you just have to download it and let it download for some time. After, once it's downloaded, what you have to do is go to your settings and then go to your system update, and then on the top right there is a three dot button, click on that and then choose the local folder. So once you choose the local folder, you can choose the file. It will automatically show the file of the latest update, so you can click on that and it will start installing the Oxygen OS 5.1.6. So that's it, guys. It's so easy to update to the latest version. So I hope that you have liked this video. If you have, please leave a like and also share this video with your friends and subscribe to GadgetCraft for more such videos. And also subscribe so that you can get all the updates in the community tab. I hope that you have liked this video. So yeah, if you have any queries, please put it in the comments below. So until next time, bye-bye.